Hello, my name is Ákos. Let me share some best practices how to create execution plans which are not only going to be beautiful, but also going to be followed by project teams. Effective strategies for teams to follow your execution plan. Let me start with a background story. We used to be BIM managers ourselves as well, created lots of execution plans in the past 15 years. We realized that in many cases these execution plans were not followed, not read, and were not put in action. So that's when we realized we have to do it somehow differently. We have to come up with a new process in order to make sure that these execution plans are followed, successful execution. We are now in a lucky position that we have over 75,000 users on a global scale. So we are in daily contact with BIM managers, understanding their challenges, hearing from their problems that they are facing on a daily basis, and fine-tuning the processes that in the past 15 years. So let's see how we can solve it. When it comes to a creation of collaborative agreements, the main focus is to not to have a long document, which is a copy and paste of other documents, but to really have targeted agreements with your teams, making sure that you are breaking down this unstructured data into easy to understand and easy to manage document sections. And you can release these document sections as they become available. You don't have to wait till you assemble 30 pages, but as soon as these documents become available, you can invite your collaborators. They can give you feedback, which means that we fully all understand why we are doing BIM and how we are going to reach our targets on a given project. The involvement of the teams and having these approval workflows and having the approval from each and every team would also mean that the buy-in into this project execution is much, much, much higher. Therefore, the plan is going to be followed. Make it available for each and every team member on your project at any point in time. When it comes to understanding who is doing what at a certain point in time, we have to identify the BIM use cases, the components and deliverables, and in this matrix, we can easily communicate what is requested from the teams. We can also communicate who is responsible for the deliverables at a certain point in time. And on these information containers, we can start discussing, of course, geometry, information requirements. So information requirements, which eventually in our BIM world are going to be translated into modeling properties, that's something to be communicated and easily understood in a visual interface. Again, helping also your executives understanding what we are doing, how we are doing that, and why we are doing that. Last but not least, receiving models is a beautiful thing. It means that we have progress on the project, but are those models aligned with your plan? That's a big question. And traditionally, it used to be taking a lot of time to check in any kind of application, setting up rule sets, setting up filters to understand that the model created meets the requirements. Now we can automate it and make it autonomous. Automated model checking means that the models can automatically be checked against the contractual requirements, and with a very simple visual feedback, you would understand if they meet the requirements or not. A green means good, other colors mean not that good. But you can make it autonomous as well. So giving this same technology to your suppliers, they can perform the quality check. So you, as the receiving BIM manager, you wouldn't even have to worry about bad quality models because it is already kind of passing a number of automated checking before the model gets to you. Last but not least, let's talk about ISO 19650 for a second as well. A beautiful standard released a couple of years ago that will help us AEC professionals to work to the same direction. Implementing the standard might be a little bit overwhelming sometimes. So what we are also doing is making sure that if you are using Planoly, you can stay aligned with the standard in a simplified way. So, and Planoly is not only supporting the standard as a framework, but having templates in the application, you see on the screen OIR, PIR, EIR, BEP, risk, mobilization plan, and so on. It allows you again to stay aligned with ISO 19650 and gives you a kickstart to start following the ISO 19650 processes. So please take a look. And if you take a look, make sure that you visit planoly.com. That's where you can learn about our ISO 19650 approach, but you can read great case studies and other learning material that you will find in our training or BIM blogs sections. So make sure to follow us on our website, but also in social media. Look for the hashtag SmartLeanBIM or PlanalyAC on the different channels, YouTube, LinkedIn, and to find us and start chatting with us.